the official source.
Jonathan Davis for umpHub.com. I'm here today with Andrew Prater, the founder of Baseball Solutions and a former professional catcher. And Andrew, tell us what happens as a catcher, especially one at the professional level, as you're moving up the ranks. What are the things that you do to make a pitch both look good for an umpire and also maybe look a little bit better than it actually is for an umpire?
Well, Jonathan, a lot of that's going to have to do with my body and where I'm setting up with my shoulders. Naturally, the baseline for giving my signs is going to be right down the middle of the plate. If I call an inside pitch, I'm going to move off with my left foot here and really keep the center of my body, my chin, on the inside part of the plate here. If I'm moving to an outside pitch, I'm going to do the same. You know, one of the mistakes that I see a lot of catchers make is too much hand movement. So if I set up on the inside part of the plate and there's a pitch that's on the black, you know, catchers want to use a lot of hand movement to try to bring pitches back. And the truth is, really, I can keep my glove, keep my thumb under the ball, and catch that pitch. I'm now showing you a lot of glove over the plate. I've actually caught the ball right here in the center of my mitt, but you're seeing a lot of glove over the plate. Obviously, I could have caught the ball here. From time to time, as I try to buy a little more space on that inner half, I'll move over just slightly more, keeping my chin right there on that inner half, and I can catch a ball that's further out. Right here is the ball I'm catching. It's off the black, but you're still seeing part of my mitt here on the plate. So those are a couple things that I did as a catcher to try to get that extra inch or two on the inside without having to move my glove and turn it. We hear this term framing it. The other mistake I see a lot of catchers make, and I think good umpires will understand, is if I have to turn my glove over or I get my thumb from under the ball to turning over this way, anything that goes this way is a ball automatic. And I was resigned the longer I played to understand that if I had to turn my glove over, then that was a ball. But man, when I could keep my thumb under the ball, I could set up here and stick the ball, we call it, and keep my thumb under the ball, then oftentimes I was showing the umpire that pitch wasn't as low as it may appear to be. I keep my thumb under the ball, and I'm able to do that.
Andrew, as an umpire, I often look at glove movement as being detrimental to that pitch and the chances of that pitch being a strike. What is the difference for you between moving your glove just enough for that pitch to make it try to look better versus you trying to sell something and you clearly know it's not a strike?
Well, the way to think about that topic, Jonathan, is to think in terms of if it's a ball, I catch it and I throw it back. If it's a strike, I give you a pregnant pause, a beat, we call it. One thing, again, we talked earlier about some mistakes catchers make. We're setting up off the plate, and rather than keeping our thumb under the ball and catching a ball, showing some umpire some glove over the plate, catchers want to try to do too much, start turning their glove. I'm in agreement. The more hand movement, the more moving, it looks like we're trying to manipulate the pitch. But if I've established with you, though, that I can catch this ball, thumb under it, show you some glove over the plate, yet it's still on the inner half, and I can show that consistently throughout the game, you know, for me, that is helping my pitcher get an edge at different stages of the game. He's established that pitch. I'm showing you a little hand movement, keeping it quiet, thumb under the ball. If I'm doing that for you and I'm giving you that consistency, then for me, I've earned that pitch and we're working good together. If the whole game, I'm bringing the glove in and I'm swooping the glove around and doing that stuff, and then I might stick one right there. You know, I haven't earned that pitch from an umpire. So naturally for me, more hand movement is not good. But if you're working with a catcher that's nice and firm and stiff and he's showing you a lot of glove over that plate, that to me is an advantage.
And lastly, is there anything that you do with your feet or your shoulders to also impact how a pitch looks for an umpire?
Yeah, exactly, Jonathan. Anytime, in my opinion, that my glove gets outside my shoulders at any time, then, you know, I forfeited a consistent strike of the strike zone. So if I'm moving in, if I'm moving out, or if I'm down the middle of the plate, if I'm keeping the glove and I'm receiving the ball in the center of my body or just off center with my thumb under the ball, then then we're operating in an efficient zone there. Anytime I go outside my body, my thumb goes up or above my chin and go in that direction, the ball's exited the strike zone.
This has been Andrew Prater, and I'm Jonathan Davis for umpHub.com.